Is it audible? Good morning.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just, we will recall what we have seen in the last class. So we have seen about spanning tail guard. So in a transparent bridge, the main drawbacks, if you are using two bridges in between the LAN to establish the connection, so automatically looping problem will be happening. To overcome that, so we are going for a spanning tree algorithm, which will identify the best, the respective path. Then it will the block unwanted ports. If you are blocking unwanted ports, automatically we can be able to avoid the looping concept. So the spanning tree algorithm, we'll just recall, then we'll see a few problems. So the first step, always you have to identify the root bridge. Because if you take any the normal the tree, the root is very important. That is the center point. So the first step, we are going to find the root bridge. So root bridge is nothing but the bridge which contains the lowest bridge ID. Sometimes we may give bridge ID, since it is a physical device, the combination of the priority plus MAC address. Sometimes the bridge ID will be given as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So depending upon the given situations, given condition, first step we have to identify the root bridge. So second step, we have to identify the root port for the remaining bridges with reference to the root bridge. Because second step, we are going to identify the port which is used to establish the connection between other bridges with the root bridge. How will we find that? So we are going to calculate the cost path for different path, the cost. Then we are selecting the path port which is going through with the least cost path. If tie is happening, suppose if the both path cost is equal, then we are going to select the root port such that which contains the lowest port ID. Which contains the lowest port ID. That is the second step. Third step, with respect to the LAN, because we are going to connect various LAN using the bridges. So first step, we identify the root bridge. Second step, we identified the port which is used to establish a connection between the root bridge with the remaining bridges. Third step, we are going to find the designated bridge and port for each LAN with respect to the root bridge. The similar way, we are going to calculate the cost for the several the possible paths. Then which is containing at the lowest cost, we are going to select the respective bridge as a designated bridge and the port. Again, if the tie is happening, we are going to select the designated bridge which contains the lowest bridge ID. Then we are going to mark all the root port, designated bridge and port in the given diagram. So the remaining and the ports are the block ports, which are unused the ports that is not required to establish the connections. So those ports are identified as the block ports. So last class, we have seen one problem with the equal the path cost. So this class also, we will see the few problems. Because the spanning tree algorithm, it is the very, very important as a network engineer and as a communication engineer, if you are going to create any the network, so you should know how to able to avoid the looping by using spanning tree. So we will see the different combination of problems, even not only as a network engineer. If you take an exam point of view also, this problem, it plays a vital role. So my advice, my request, you kindly solve few problems, then only it is very easy for you to solve in the examinations.
Sir, I think your screen has not been shared, sir.
Yeah, I will share. Just I recalled the previous class.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay. So the problem, the first one. So now it is clear. Can you able to view the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So given the extended LAN shown below, indicate which ports are not selected by the spanning tree. That means you have to identify the block ports. Here, the red bar you see here. Let assume. So just a minute. Sir, ask. So here, you know, let assume the port number is the linking cost. That last class problem we have seen with the equal cost. Then we assume the cost is one. Here in this given problem, if you see here, the port number is the linking cost. That means from LAN A to B7 through port 1, so the respective cost is 2. In this link, that is cost is 1. In this link, cost is 2. Here cost is 1. Here cost is 2. Similarly, you know that respective port number, it is nothing but the linking cost. So depending upon the conditions, we have to compute the respective the least cost part. So the first step, so the step one, so you have to solve step by step directly, you know, without the solving. If you are writing the answer, that won't be considered for an evaluation. So the first one, it is nothing but the root bridge. Root bridge, it is nothing but which contains the lowest bridge ID. Here we are not giving any MAC address. That means, you know, this B1, B2, B3, it is a respective bridge ID. You see here, so B1, it is the lowest, the value. One is the lowest value. So B1, it is nothing but the root bridge. The first step, root bridge, it is B1. Step two, the root port. Root port is nothing but we are going to select the port for each and every the bridge with respect to the root bridge. So first we are going to find the root port for B2. So different the combination of path. So from B3 to B1, either you can go here or you can go here or you can go in this direction also. So we have to find the cost for each and every part. So the first step, B2, 1, 2, LAN A. So the first path, B2 port 1 to LAN A plus second one, LAN A to B7 1, LAN A to B7 1 plus B7 2 to LAN C. E7 port 2 to LAN C plus LAN C to B11. LAN C to B11. This is the first path. This is path 1. Similarly, for path 2, let us assume this is path 1, path 2. Path 3. So path 2, B to 3, that is third port to D, land D. B to third port to land D plus land D to B3 port number 1, land D to B3 port number 1, land D to B3 port number 1, then B3 port number 5 to land E, B3 port number 5 to land E, B3 port number 5 to land E plus LAN E to B12. So LAN E to B12. Then third path. So B2 to LAN B in this path. So B2 port number 2 LAN B. Then LAN B2 B5 port 1. B5 port 2 to LAN F. So this is the third path. So B2 to LAN B, B2 to LAN B. So next one, LAN B2 B5 port number 1. So LAN B2 port number, LAN B2 port number 1 of B5, B5 1 plus B5 2 to LAN F, B5 2 to LAN F plus LAN F2 B3 2, LAN F2 B3 2, LAN F2 V32 plus V3 52 LAN E, V3 52 LAN E plus LAN E to B12. So LAN E to B12. Any doubt here? Shall we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. Thank you. Yeah. Now we have to calculate the cost. As per given things, the port number is the linking cost. In this problem, port number is the linking cost. So the we will find the cost for the path 1. So B212 LAN A. B212 LAN A. Here, this is the port number, this is the linking cost. So, linking cost here 1. Here, linking cost is LAN A to B71. So, 1 is the linking cost. 1 is the linking cost. Plus, here, B27 LAN C. B27 LAN C. So sorry, P7 to LAN C. So 2 is the port number, 2 is the linking cost, 2 plus here 1 is the linking cost. So the total cost 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. For the path 2, similarly, port number is linking cost. So here B23, so 3 is the port number. So 3 plus B31. So, 1 is the port number, that is the linking cost, plus B35, 5 is the port number, that is linking cost, plus 2. So, it is equal to 5, 7, 8, 11. So, the path 1, 5 is the cost, path 2, 11 is the cost. Similarly, path 3, so port number 2, so 2 is the linking cost, port number 1, so 1 is the linking cost. Port number 2. So 2 is the linking cost. Port number 2. So 2 is the linking cost. port number 5. So 5 is the linking cast. Port number 2. So 2 is linking cast. So total 2, 3, 5, 7, 12, 14. So automatically the path 1, it is the least cast path. So V2 path 1. So V2 path 1, this is linking cast. That means the root port for B2, it is the port 1. This is the root port. So for B2, port 1 is the root port. For B2, so port 1 is the root port. So similar way, you have to find for remaining. In the examinations, so the detailed linking path, you can write maybe one or two bridges, then remaining you can calculate automatically, directly you can calculate. So directly you can calculate. So similarly, we are going for B3. So we are going for B3. So after calculating, you have to create the table for the root port. After calculating all these things, you have to create the root port table. So for B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, B7. For B2, port number 1, it is the root port. Similarly, for B3, we will calculate. Next for B3. So from B3, different path. This is path 1. This is another path. Then all the remaining are always, you know, it should be greater than that cast because it is repeating of the same thing. So let us consider this is path 1, path 2, path 3. So path 1, we see that linking cast 5 plus 2. So 5 plus 2, 7. In a path 2, so 1 plus 3 plus 1. So 1 plus 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. So here 9 is the respective linking cast. Path 3, 2 plus 2, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12. Here it is 12. Now if we compare all these things, path 1, it contains the lowest the cast, least cast. So automatically for B3, the 5 is the root port. So for B3, 5 is the root port. So B3, 5. Finally, we have to compute the respective root port for all the bridges. Then for B4, so B4, this is 1, another one, it may go here, if we calculate the cost, 1 plus 4, 5, 10 plus 2, 12, here it is the 12. Second path, 2 plus 2, 4, 13, 14, 16, 17. So automatically for B4, the respective path 1, it is the first path. So here, the respective, the root port, it is not B4, 1. So now, this is the root port. So for B4, 1 is the root port. Similarly, next we are going to compute the respective root port for B5. So bridge 5, this is 1, this is the another 1, so this way, this is 1, this is 2, so if you calculate the cost, 1, plus 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. So 8 is the cost. In this path 2, 2, 4, 9, plus 11. 11 is the respective cost. Automatically, the least, the path is, cost path is path 1. That is for the B5, port 1 is the root port. So for B5, 1 is the root port. Similarly, for next is for the B6. So B6, so either you can go here, or you can go here, or you can go here. So in this path, 1 plus 3, 4 plus 5, 9 plus 2, 11. Here it is 11. In this path, 2, 4, 5, 9, 14, 16. So here in the third path, 1, 4, 5, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13. So automatically, so this is the least cost path. So for B6, port 1, it is the root port. So for B6, 1 is the root port. So similarly for B7. For B7, for B7, this is 1, this is 2. See here, 2 plus 1, 3. Here 1, 2, 5, 6, 11, 13. Automatically, you see here, this is the least cost path. So for B7, 4, 2 is the root port. For B7, 2 is the root port. So now we have calculated root port for all the bridges with respect to the respective the road bridge. Any doubt? Okay. So next step, we have to find the designated bridge and the port for all the land with respect to the road bridge. That is the third step. Step 3. So designated bridge and port. Designated bridge and port. The same way. So first for land A. So from LAN A to this B1, either you can go here or you can go here. So similar way, you have to write the path, then you have to calculate the cost. So here, if you see here, from A to B1, 1 plus 2, 3 plus 1, 4. Path 2, 1 plus 3, 4, 5, 10, 12. So the least cost path, it is nothing but through B7, 1. So for LAN A to the road bridge, the least cost path is nothing but through B7, 1. So B7, 1 is the designated bridge and port. Kindly mark it. For LAN A, B7, 1 is the designated bridge and port. So here also you have to create the table. So for each LAN, you have to find the designated bridge and port. For LAN A, B7, 1. B7, 1. Similarly, LAN B, calculate for LAN B. So LAN B, this is one path. This is the another path. So the first path for LAN B, 2 plus 1, 3, 4, 6, 7. In this angle for LAN B, 1 plus 2, 3, 5, 10, 12. Here it is 12. So automatically for LAN B, this B2, 2 is the designated bridge and port. Because this path, the cost is 7. This path, the cost is 12. Automatically for LAN B, B2, 2 is the designated bridge and port. So B2, 2 for LAN B. For LAN B, it is B2, 2, port number 2. Similarly, we are going to calculate for the LAN C. So for LAN C, this is one path, this is second path. Automatically, if you see here the cost is from LAN C to B1, it is 1. So remaining, it is higher than that. So for LAN C, so B1, 1 is the designated port. It is very, very clear. For LAN C, B1, 1. For LAN C, B1, 1. Next is for LAN D. LAN D. This is one path. This is another path. Here, if you see here, LAN D, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. Here, 1, 5, plus 2, 8. Now, tie is happening. LAN D to B1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. 1, 5, 2, 8. Now, if you see here, for LAN D, tie is happening. If tie is happening, how will you select the designated bridge which contains lowest bridge height? So, for LAN 3, B2, and B3, both are, it is, the cost is equal. So we are going to select the root bridge if tie is happening, which contains the lowest bridge ID. So comparing to B3, B2 is the lowest bridge ID. So for land D, B2, 3 is the designated port. Kindly clear note down, for land D, B2, 3 is the designated bridge and port. So similarly, we are going to calculate for next one. If tie is happening, you should select with the lowest bridge ID as a designated bridge. Then next is for LAN E. It is clearly indicating that it is for B21. For LAN E, this is one path, this is another path. Automatically, clearly it is understand that the here cost is 2. This is the lowest comparing to all other paths. So now, this is the designated. So for E, B12. For E, B12. Next, for F. For F, where is F? Yeah. So this is one path. This is the another path. In this path, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. In this 2, 7, 9. So this is the lowest automatically for LAN F B3 2. It is the designated port. For LAN F B3 2. For LAN F B3 2. Similarly, we are going to calculate for next LAN. Next is for G. So LAN G, this is G. So LAN G, you can go in this direction, or you can go here, or you can go here also. So 4, 5, 9. 4, 5, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13. In this direction, it is higher than these two. So automatically for G1, B3, 4, it is a designated port. This is the lowest one. So for G, B3, 4. For G, B3, 4. Next is for H. For H, this is one. This is second. In this part, 3, 8, 10. Here, 1, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15, 17. Ultimately, for H, B3. 3 is the designated port. H is B3, 3. For H, B3, 3. B3, 3. Then similarly for I. So for I, either we can go here or we can go here. You see here 2, 3, 7, 12, 14. Here 2, 3, 6, 11, 13. So automatically compared this, this is the lowest. So for ID62, it is an the designated port. D62, it is a designated bridging port for ID62. It is a designated bridging port. So now we have found an respect designated bridge port for all the LANs with respect to root bridge. The last step, the block ports, which is not having either as a designated bridge port or root port, then remaining all the ports are, it is nothing but the block ports. If you see here the block ports, directly we can, even we can mention in the diagram itself. So for V1, both the ports are including. For B7, this is D, this is R. For B2, all the three ports are, it is there. For B5, port 1 is R, port 2 is, it is empty, it is not in the forwarding table, so it is a block port. It is a block port. For B3, port 1 is not there anywhere, it is a block port. 2 is there, 3 is there, 4 is there, 5 is there. For B4, port 1 is the root port, B2 is empty. For B6, 1 and 2 is there, 3 is then empty. Now, the last step, the block ports. The step 4, block ports. So, block ports are B5, 2, B5, 2, then B3, 1, B3, 1, B4, 2, B6, 3, B4, 2, B6, 3. So these are all the four block ports for the given problems. So this way you can be able to find a root port, that is root bridge, root port, distant bridge and port, the block ports. Kindly refer this problem, because you know this will be very, very important in terms of exam point of view also. Okay. So kindly listen. So tomorrow class has been postponed to Monday 11 a.m. I have checked in the beta. So during Monday 11 a.m. all the students are free. So therefore tomorrow morning 8 o'clock session, the class has been postponed to Monday 11 a.m. You kindly join on Monday 11 a.m. Based on that only the tomorrow attendance will be given. Yes, you know, actually I am on leave. Today I have taken the class. Even afternoon also we'll have a lab, but tomorrow the first hour class has been the post.